racers skate for gold. And here's how the final works. As I said, the top six from the series, which spanned the globe, 6 weeks of competitions to get to the top six. That's your final lineup. Three rounds to the final. The first two have already taken place, getting set for round three with 50% of the total score. And the two free skates or free dances must be different. In ice stands, here are the six who made it here. In order, after two rounds, here are the standings. Anastasia Pezhura, born in Kratz at the top. No real surprise there, but how about this shocker? Fusarpoli and Margaglio of Italy, the reigning world champions, are all the way down in fourth place right now. And by the way, in round three, they'll skate in inverse order of the standings. Hi, everybody. Terry Gannon here. We're thrilled to have you along as we continue. Here is the panel of seven judges and the countries which they're from.
And Sergei Sakhnovsky.
So here we go. Round three, set to get underway. The final free dance with a gold medal. All the medals will be decided out there. Right now from Israel, Galit Chait and Sergei Sakhnovsky, a team that has really made a meteoric rise up the ladder in the last few years. Currently in fifth.
They have skated this program well all season, making no mistakes. Very consistent. The music, Havana Gila.
Free dance, 4 minutes long. As I mentioned, worth 50% of the overall score.
This is a very strong pass here. Footwork, and then lifts put within the footwork. They're able to maintain their flow. The elements in the free dance, dance lifts, that's a rotational lift that rotates three times. The lifts are very strong. In ice dancing, unlike pair skating, you have to skate so close together. You can see here, these are dance holds. And you can't rely on stock moves like triple saukows and quads. It's all about the dance and the relationship to the music.
Spoken like a true ice dancer. We'll get Peter Carruthers over here to debate you.
And lifts like these, a change of curve. He's on one circle and then changes direction with one foot, showing great control.
If you're a figure skating fan, you may know their story. Galit Chait was born in Israel. When she was 9 months old, her family moved to New York. She grew up as an American. When she was 9 years old, she went skating for the first time. It was at Rockefeller Center. Sergei Sakhnovsky is originally from Moscow, made his way to Israel searching for a partner, and eventually found one in America when he got together with Galit.
They're very well suited for one another. Are well matched.
Oh,
this team is that they give you a full performance. They don't hold back, and that's commendable.
Was that the best that you've seen them this year?
I have to say, probably yes. They also had a great skate at Cup of Russia, equal to that.
Three silver medals in the Grand Prix series. They were hoping for more here, but in fifth place heading into this round three, but trying to move up with a good effort.
They are a strong team, but their weakness lies in the footwork. They can get better pushes, more edge quality, and firmer dance holds. And watch this change of direction lift. He will be on one curve in a spread eagle position. Then they transition, and here he balances on one foot. That takes a lot of power.
5-4.
Now,
five,
there'll be two sets of marks,
five,
as always.
Five, four,
and in this free dance, the first set is for technical merit.
Marks
there they are, Susie. Mid-fives.
Well, some of these marks, the 5-3,
five,
seem
seven,
low, but this
five,
is not
six,
their strength.
5-8.
And the
five,
presentation
seven,
marks, the overall
five,
artistry
five,
of that program, 5.5
five,
up to 5.8
five.
Five for Chait and Sakhnovski.